Give me a kiss. Oh, thank you. Love you.
Thank you. afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Shelly and Kareem, along with their family and friends, would like to invite you to the house of God. We want to recognize the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. We'd like to ask you to help us lift up his name.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank God for you, my love, my friend, my bride, all my life.
Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmeet for him. The Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh thereof, and the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made him a woman and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of me. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. The Lord put Adam to sleep, took one of his ribs, and created the woman around the rib. Man was made of the dust of the earth. Woman was made of the flesh of Adam. She was not made as low as he was. He was made strictly from dust. She was made of something finer. She was a second work of God, beyond and greater than man. The Lord said, it's not good for man to be alone. But for this reason, this is the reason the Lord said that a man should be his father and mother, even his wife. Because the dividing and the separating is more essential. Because you came out of your mother. You're going under your wife. She's been born of you by God. The division, the separation must be from God. You must divide yourself emotionally, spiritually from your mother and your father so that the two of you can be one. Well, the scripture commands the husband to love his wife. Nowhere in the scripture does it say that the woman must love her husband. Reason being is because God put a little extra bit of himself on woman, in the sense that a woman understands love far more than men. So she doesn't have to be told to love. Men must be constantly reminded to love. Because of the way we are, because men are made of the dust of the earth, and because our lives are so focused on things other than family, wives, children, Lord Jesus Christ has determined that a man must have something beyond strict emotion to keep him committed to a relationship. Therefore, God has required that we make vows to each other. That our relationship not be built on emotion, but commitment. Commitment made first of all before him, second of all before all of these people. A vow. The scripture says it's better never to make a vow than it is to make it and break it. It would be better after all of this for you to turn to these people and say, we've made a mistake. And so that and in God's eyes, to make a vow and then turn from that vow to leave that. Regardless of the reason. Praise God. If you understand the purpose of the vow, and you're willing to enter into this kind of commitment inside of God. Please answer by saying, I will, if this be the conviction and the decision of your heart. Kareem, will you accept this woman from God to be your wife, to live together according to the dictates of God's word, the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her as you do your own self? Comfort her, provide for her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself for her only so long as you both live. Shelly, are you willing to be given to this man for his wife, to accept his name and his life's purpose? Do you accept him as your husband to live together according to the word of God and the holy bonds of marriage? Will you obey him, reverence and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? Keep yourself for him only so long as you both share. I'd like for you to face each other. We're going to make our vows to each other. I'd like you to repeat each part of the vow after me. Hi, Kareem. Thank you, Shelly. Be my wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. That parts us. By faith in God's word and spirit. By faith in God's word and spirit. I now pledge to you my faith. I, Shelley, take you, Kareem, to be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love, cherish, and obey. Till death parts us. My faith in God's word and spirit. I now place thee my faith. Now exchange rings, and it's important for you to understand that these rings, we do not exchange them so that you have something to wear on your fingers. The purpose is to remind you of the vows you made today. In just a few moments' time, all of this will be nothing but a memory. At best, you can watch the video or look at the pictures, but even that, the emotions and all of the memory of this will not be as keen as today. All of this, you will not be married tomorrow because of this today. Not because of this ceremony and all of this. You'll be married tomorrow because you've made a commitment before God. And the purpose of exchanging these rings is this is the only thing that you'll come in contact with every day for the rest of your lives that reminds you not of this wedding ceremony, but of the vows that you've made to each other today. You don't feel like keeping the vow. You've given a ring that says, this is a token. I've given you this in pledge that what I said the day we were married, I meant every word of it. Regardless of how convenient or inconvenient it is to me, I'm going to keep my vow. You can count on me. This is the only thing you will take from this day that will become a part of your everyday life. Not your license. You may never look at your license again. You'll still be married. You may never put your wedding gown on ever again. You'll still be married. But the ring today is intended to be a reminder that before God and these people, you have vowed to be one together till death part. If you're willing to seal your vows with these rings, accept them from me. Hold them, please, and repeat together after me. As a pledge and in token of the vows that were made between us, with this ring, I thee wed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me place the ring on her. Lord Jesus Christ, by the authority of your word, through the power of your spirit, I ask you to make this couple one in you, in Jesus' name. Let your spirit rest upon them. Let your spirit move in and through each of them. Bring them together, make them one, enable them to love each other, not according to worldly love or human love, the far superior love of your love flowing through each of them to the other. Let your blessing be upon them, God. Let your anointing be upon their lives. Let their commitment to you be stronger and more firm than their commitment to each other, so that their relationship can be blessed in you and through you and by you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, take their lives and use them for your glory, not only individually, but now is this new union, this new person that you're bringing together, the two halves making the whole, Lord. Grant this today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I give you the praise and the honor and the glory for it. Amen. What God has joined together, let no man. For as much as Kareem and Shelly have consented together in holy wedlock, and witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their faithfulness to each other, and declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, by joining hands, by the authority of the state of Maryland, and most importantly, the Lord Jesus Christ. I now pronounce you husband and wife.
He's the best looking guy here.
Hey, look at the big girls. Come on around here.
Oh, is that for me?
No, that's my man.
Hey, come on, y'all. I gotta get all y'all in the picture.
Hey, little guys, come on.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. What do you think?
Two minutes.
Robbie, Mom? Robin, where is she? Which one? Robin.
Oh,
straight
ahead.
With the brown leather?
With the brown leather?
Thank you. Being adored, the mother and father of the bride, is Sandra and Eugene Gaither. The father and mother of the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Gary Cooper. The ring bearer, Kai Coates. Yeah. Orlando and Rihanna Simpson. Yeah. Terry and Simone. Alicia. Yeah. Antoine and Joey. Nathan and Nikki. Adrian and Candy. Parrish and Bridget. Curtis and Christine. Leroy and Sabrina. Tim and Rebecca. Jermaine and Lori. Mark and Stephanie. Chris and Kia. Ashley and Kimberly. Danielle and Angel. This time, I'd like to announce Kareem and his lovely wife, Shelly.
Jesus, thank you for this day. Thank you for all that you've done for us. Thank you for this opportunity for our fellowship. We ask that you would bless this food, bless this couple, bless this day. Let your presence be in our midst today. In Jesus' name, bless and sanctify the food and the nourishment of our bodies. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Zoom right in on you when you're eating.
Thank you. can do better. Wave your hands if you can do better.
For those of you that feel like I do, let's do better. Clean up what I messed up. Start my life over again. Yeah. Clean up what I messed up.
You with another song. Said, I come from a poor family. I didn't have much, but the Lord been good to me.
Yes.
stop looking hearted. Oh, yeah. Please stop looking hearted. Shout, shout, shout.
Really not good at speeches. Oh no. Since I'm in the spotlight right now, I would like for everyone right now to raise their glasses in the air.
There we go.
These two, I've kind of been with them through their tough times and their bad, well, the tough times and their good times. Of course, when you know there were two separate individuals before today, they've pretty much been had this need for each other, and you know, to feel complete and whole, you know, all together. And well, today's a great day to be here. I'm glad to be here, and I hope you all are. I just hope that their future, and as well as right now, will be great, and you know, many more great days to them. And hey, let's toast.
Oh yeah, buddy.
Don't take off the jet.
Superman.
I'm a saver of a woman waiting from a tall building.
Woo!